Okay, we're going to do a similar exercise to what we did in the previous spreadsheet, but now we are going to vary the price of good X rather than varying income, which we did in the previous spreadsheet. The preferences that are here are a little bit different than the ones before. Before, we're actually in a quadratic world. That's how I was able to derive inferior goods and be able to plot the income consumption path. To enable me to plot this price consumption curve here, I've changed the preferences. We're now in what's called a Stone-Geary world, so the preferences are a little different, and as a result, the controls have changed a bit. So let me show that for a second. Let's move over here and move down. You have two different controls. You can change income and you can change price. That is, you can affect the budget line, but there is no control now for the preferences. So the preferences are going to stay fixed in this exercise. And what I am going to do now is vary the price of X. Let's raise the price a little bit. Let's raise it a lot. That moves the intercept on this axis in. Notice that the choice point, as I raise it, stays on this dotted curve, which is the price consumption curve. So the price consumption curve shows the choice point as we vary the price of X. And there I'm raising it. And now let's lower it back again. And when you lower the price of X, you're getting more X. You can show that relationship here. Let's move further to the right here. So here's that same choice point. Now I'm plotting the price of X against the quantity of good X. And as I lower the price, let's lower it again. I get more of good X as I raise the price. I get less of good X. So the demand curve for X, as we expect, slopes down. Let's go back to the original diagram. I want to make one more observation about this price consumption curve. You can actually infer elasticity of demand for good X by the following. Along the price consumption curve, for changes in the price of X, the price of Y is staying fixed. So the expenditure on Y depends on the amount of Y consumed. And you can't really tell this, but this curve is actually sloping down throughout. As I lower the price of X, I'm actually buying less Y, and therefore I'm spending less on Y. Income is also not changing. So I must be spending more income on good X as I lower its price, which means demand is actually elastic for good X. So again, you can infer demand elasticity of X from the slope of the price consumption curve by first looking at the consumption of Y, and Y consumption is falling as the price of X falls, so expenditure on X must be rising as the price of X falls.